Hey, and welcome back to another Rogues Play. The last Rogue Play. Not the last Rogue Play of forever, but the last one of playing Metal Gear Solid. Last time we escaped from a bunch of stupid soldiers. And there's cutscenes. More cutscenes. All the cutscenes. Catching up on RSC news, and now we're going to face the boss. Because that's what we do. We're going to finish our mission. Let's see if I can actually beat her in one go. Be nice. Like, the pattern, it takes a bit to get down, but then after that you're like, oh, okay, this is... It's timing. Of course, I'm not stamina killing her. I have stamina killed her, but this run-through has never been about stamina kills, because I already got the trophies and the big boss thing related to it. Now I'm just playing for fun. That's what I'm about, is fun! Fun! And finishing my mission like a good soldier. Sad face. I remember most of this episode is actually going to be cutscenes. Again. Yeah, it's funny, the gameplay in this thing is generally more less than the videos. Also, the sequence is so quiet. I mean, if you want to be super sneaky and super precise, there's multiple ways to beating her. See, his name is Jack. Jack. Anyways, the best camo that to use in this sequence is the snow camo. You can either directly attack her like this and shoot her with a shotgun, or you can snipe at her with any sniper rifle you have. Well, at least that, the sniper rifle one will work for the first part of the fight, and then she starts charging at you and you have to counter CQC. But yeah, counter CQC, knock her down. Shoot her with some weapon. For most effective, if you're not going for stamina kill, is a shotgun. Rinse, repeat. Avoid her completely messing you up, although it happens, like it just did, and hope you don't die. It's a little bit harder with the, with stamina only, because, yeah, obviously those guns don't do as much damage. And, like, I suppose if you had the most Syndicant and the 22, then that would work. But I don't think I collected the most Syndicant on this playthrough. I just did the SVD, which is the general sniper rifle. It doesn't take trank rounds. But we're just gonna beat her the old-fashioned way, with bullets. My battery controller is low, shut up! Get ready. Right now I'm not actually playing the game, so I'm commenting on it as I played it several months ago. Because, you know, life. Productions. I'm looking for you too. There you are.
There he is.
Counter. Beat her up. Beat her up. There we go. You know, I'd really like to fall backwards like that. Like, what person actually will fall like that when they get hit? I'm just like, boom, boom, boom. Into the bed of flowers. But who has a battle in a field full of flowers anyways? It's so elegant. Oh no.
Here I come.
They're flowers that when you hit them, they turn red. Like the Japanese flag. Boom. I'm still doing pretty good though. I'm like, yeah, she's dead more than I am. But yeah, you can snipe her and then she'll charge at you after the first half of the battle. But, or you could just do what I do and just chase after and let her attack you.
Get ready.
Either way generally works. There's other ways too, but these are the ways I like doing.
Run quick.
Oh god. Then I missed. Whoops. Yeah, counting your CQC is not always guaranteed. Or it's a timing issue.
Let's see.
I didn't counter her that time. Whoops. But I mean, after she fires at you, she's open to getting hit. Like that. You just have to deal with the bullets flying in her face. Five more minutes. Cue the music. Finally. That first 5 minutes is so quiet. I'm still beating you. Yeah, that's the halfway point of the battle. That's where, if you've been sniping at her, she'll start to directly charge at you. Which makes it hard to snipe at her. So learn both strategies. You'll be better for it. Actually, I'm like, I don't care if they copyright ID that thing. Whoops. Cause this is Konami's game after all.
Let's see what you're
made. Oh, sorry. It's 11:52. It's nearly midnight here. I think I explained in the last episode that I've actually been having a normal sleep schedule. Thanks to school. Yay.
School.
It feels so weird to be back in school, but I know it's because I need to learn a new skill to be successful at what I want to do. But it's not like I'm just going to be doing school, it's also I've got work too, so. Even for my first time in college. First time in college, there wasn't much work where I was going to school at. It was a really small retirement town. 3 more minutes and you're almost dead. So jobs were kind of hard to find, especially if you didn't have a car, which I didn't. I didn't have a car in the middle of retirement town in Florida. Whoops. Oh, the vocals do start after the 3 minute mark. Okay. Oh dear. Snake, don't do that again.
Brace yourself.
Fall straight down. Kablooey. Run away. Yeah, I'm just marveling how much more of this is a cutscene. Counter. Oh shit, she double countered me. Shut up, you're pathetic. There we go. Yeah, that's one or two more shots and she's done. I'm gonna say two. Well, maybe one. So I'm like, 1 more minute, I'm cutting it really to the wire. Oh, yep, and she's down. Dramatic. Dramatic sadness. Because we have to respect this scene. Oh shit, the Philosopher's Legacy. I'm really curious what's on those microfilms. I'm like, are they bank account numbers? Are they plans to take over the world? Plans to build a nuclear Metal Gear? Because why do I need it? I'm almost dead. Duh.
There's only room for one boss and one snake.
Snake goo. So sadness. Sadness. No, I can't look. I can't look. So are you gonna do it? I think this part I was like, what's going on here?
Well, I'm sorry.
Rogue
seems to have disappeared into space for just a moment. In the meantime, a little music, and we'll hope to rejoin the program just as soon as we possibly can.
Okay, I'm back now. I swear I had to take a time out and eat some Jell-O and get another soda and cry a bit. No, not cry a bit. Actually, my video camera was out of memory, but we just be the bus. I'm gonna stare at the flowers and be sad. And they all turn red. So dramatic. Like they're being stained with her blood energy. If she had that much blood coming from her, I'd be amazed at that. Oh shit, I feel a disturbance in the Force. Do you feel a disturbance in the Force? Oh no, it's her horse. Her horse could be sad too. And then I'm just like, you're just gonna leave the horse in Russia? I guess you'd have a hard time getting it through import, through customs. However you get back to America. It's okay, then the Russian horse will be snake. That's so creepy. That is so creepy. Her scar turns into a snake. That's where it breaks reality. They didn't say, like, you know, kill her and then chop off her head for posterity. Or send us a photo film of her of her tits Oh, gosh. I'm just thinking about Orange is the New Black's that last season. That's nowadays. Nowadays, when you kill somebody, you have to take a selfie in front of the body and then show off the goods. Meanwhile, plane. Plane.
Ready to go, yeah. Snake?
He doesn't even answer. That's how heartbroken he is.
Are you okay?
Killed my mentor. How do you think I feel? Jeez. Metal Gear.
Told you could trust me.
Cool. We're getting out of here, finally. Oop. Wait a minute. What's going on here? Get us! Oh, it's him. Ocelot.
We're not.
Yes, we are. No, we're not. If you rode all the way here just to something, then I guess we're not done. You knocked off the door.
Damn.
Guess you're not cleared to go beyond 24,000 feet. No pressurized cabins. No! My weapons! Ocelot, you're such a pain in the butt. But you're lovable pain in the butt. No, I do like Ocelot. He's so cute with this game. And I don't mean like attractive, I just mean adorable. He's such a tryhard. All of them are tryhards. But that's what you have to be in order to succeed. You have to be a tryhard sometimes. And then whether or not you succeed, well, the advantage of you have an edge over the competition. Seize those opportunities and take advantage of them. Obi-Wan? I don't know CQC, I just know Ocelot Fu. Yeah, it's just like, it's Ocelot Fu.
Not
shit,
good.
We're too heavy! Ocelot, you weigh too much! Oh yeah, because they burnt out the engine. He killed the engine, so yeah. Oh, that's a cat. Playing with a mouse. A toy mouse. Ouch. Yeah, it's just Ocelot Fu. It's like, is it Sambo? Is it Krav Maga? No, I don't think it's either of those. It's just Ocelot Fu. From where? The jungle?
New moves.
Aside from playing Russian roulette forever? Oh no, here we go again.
Huh. Doesn't feel
oh,
right.
Geez.
Unarmed
draw.
But I'll get over it. Eva.
Oh, there we go. There, now it's a fair fight. Interesting. Boys. Stop fighting in my plane! Ocelot, just get the hell off!
One
last showdown, fine.
Showdown.
I don't remember how this is randomized, but you actually in this upcoming scene have the choice of three or four videos. And I forget which one I get this go around. Do I get the funny one, the serious one, or something else entirely? Of course I'd watch them with my one eye. Why are you in this juggling shit? I'm so happy to be juggling shit. There you go. Have some stuff to shoot.
What's your name? Snake.
Not that name.
No.
You're not a snake, and I'm not an ocelot.
You're not a snake, and I'm not an ocelot. We're men.
We're men with names. Abimska.
What's yours?
John. So plain.
John. Very well, John. Plain name. But I won't forget it.
So we call him Snake and not Jack. It's like no one else calls him, like, Jack for, like, the entire rest of the series. Let's see which one I chose. First I was like, is there a way to tell? But I mean, like, they're both single action armies, so. Because didn't he steal one? Or didn't somebody steal one for him? Let's see which one I chose. Kablooey. And drum roll. Oh shit, you chose the wrong gun.
Looks like your luck has beat mine again. Why didn't you pull the trigger?
I'm not that kind of guy. So you have the fair ending where it's like, yeah, we're men, and I'm going to leave, so you can leave too. Bye. We shall meet eventually, because, you know, war, soldiers, they eventually meet again. Pull up! Pull up. Pull up. Pull up. I doubt they had that installed on that plane. That didn't come into use until like the 70s, if I remember correctly. The terrain system. I forget exactly what it's called. I'll look it up later. Control tabs. Yay! Oh my god, is that how many cutscenes I still have to watch? Air bubbles. Look, he can laugh.
We made it.
Yeah, sure did.
We defeated war. Now we're going someplace else. Where's the horse? Horse! You're leaving the horse! I'm so mad he left the horse. But I guess he couldn't take it with him. Zero would be like, what the fuck is this? Oh, yeah, right, Migs. But, yeah, Zero will be like, what the fuck is this? Why did you bring a horse? Maybe that's why he's like, now I'm going to invest into capturing systems so I can take the horse with me! Always! And bears, and people, and everything. I never have to leave anything on a battlefield ever again. Wow, that is a theory. That because he wasn't able to take the horse with him from his first mission, he developed an obsession which is about never leaving anything behind on the battlefield. So that's why he uses a Fulton recovery system to do everything and recover everything off a battlefield, including horses and bears and dogs. Maybe not bears. That was a comic book joke. That was a webcomic joke. Thanks, awkward zombie. You are great. Now we're about to get the hell blown up.
Hulk 19, this is Control.
Oh shit, damn.
Stand by for a direct order from the chairman. Hulk 19, return to base immediately. Do you read me? This is a direct order from Comrade Khrushchev. Return to base immediately.
Duh.
19, do you copy? Understood. Aborting mission.
Duh. Returning to base. That's what RTB stands for. Return to base.
Look! The MiGs are turning back!
Why'd they do that, Khrushchev? Are you guys gonna kiss finally? Oh, nope, phone call. Nuts. I didn't get to kiss him.
Well done, Snake.
The MiGs disengaged.
Most likely under orders from Khrushchev.
Is this his way of helping us?
Who knows? Maybe he didn't want things to get messier than they already are. Maybe
probably the
latter. Us to open one. The important thing is, you made it out alive. As long as Khrushchev is with us, I don't think they'll be coming after you. It should be smooth sailing all the way to Alaska. I'm sending someone out to Galena Base to meet you.
To meet me?
The DCI and the President himself are waiting at Langley. Don't keep them waiting.
I'll keep them waiting as long as I want. I have a rendezvous in Alaska. Like a freaking James Bond movie. Don't believe me. Yes, I want to save my game. Playing this game. Shh. Max. It got in the way. Like I said, secret rendezvous in Alaska with a fireplace and a rug. Including a tiger bearskin rug.
So what are you going to do now?
Nope.
Go back to the KGB.
Escape for me. So you can live with me.
Coming back to America.
Why not? But I'll be there. America behind me.
But you saved this country.
You saved me.
I didn't do it alone.
It's a tiger. No, it's a bear. It's a something.
And
oh, what's this? Oh, well, there's wine right now.
Is that part of your mission too? Or...
ooh.
Or is it an invitation?
It's all three of them, dear. Uh-oh.
I don't take orders from anyone now.
Okay, it's a tiger rug. Oh. It's the moment we were waiting for all game long. The secret rendezvous in... I guess it's on a tiger rug in front of a fireplace.
Open your heart and smile.
animal. Aren't you gonna get that? Not this time. Nope. Excuse me while I don't get this. Jack's like, oh shit. Oh well. I really don't care right now. Cue the brassy horns. Brassy horns! Yeah. So 1960s. Let the fires rage on all night long. Till they get so drunk he can't remember the next morning. Or maybe they didn't have any more wine. It's still there in the probably melted ice bucket. Where did they go where there was wine in a bucket? They're in Alaska. So are they in like a private hotel cabin?
Scholars tell us that the first spy in history was the snake.
Did they have to drive on a motorcycle up there and, you know,
in that story,
drop by the corner store? I'm Ava. Aw, she got the picture developed. Where? I guess Russia had photo developing facilities in that giant base? That's the only conclusion. Data tape. No, reel-to-reel tape. It's strange. It's like, Hideo Kojima really likes music and audio stuff. Because I went from reel-to-reel tapes to cassette tapes to iPod things. Personally, the cassette stuff the most.
I hope you slept well.
You traitor.
First of all, I have to apologize. I wasn't sent by Khrushchev. I'm not a KGB spy, and I never worked for the...
So many double crosses.
I'm an agent.
So many double crossings. He's like, why am I not surprised? Yeah, they must have gotten that bike from somewhere.
The philosophers still exist in China, too. You see, my mission was to find out where Volgan was hiding the philosopher's legacy and steal it. So I infiltrated his base as a KGB spy. The two NSA codebreakers who defected in 1960 were actually both men. The real Adam never showed up at the meeting place. Saving me the trouble of having to...
That's because the real Adam was, well, shh.
And you and Sokolov and Volgan.
Apparently.
You all believe me. The philosopher's legacy was originally...
Of course, I'm like, how much of this do I believe? Because I know the fourth one overwrites a lot of this crap anyway.
Let the Russians and the Americans take it all for themselves. The Chinese government had its eye on the legacy, too. I got the film containing the legacy. And also the nuclear missile launch data from the Shagahov. 5 years ago, the Soviet Union stopped supplying us with weapons technology. Since then, China's Lianda unusing hydrogen bomb and space rocket projects have fallen behind. But with this data, our country will be able to develop its own nukes. We'll create a deterrent force.
So are you Chinese?
In Soviet Union. Everything has gone according to plan, thanks to your help.
Somehow I'm not surprised. This game is so complicated.
I too am one of the philosophers.
Or, okay, you're just an agent.
The philosophers, a graduate of one of their charm schools.
Oh, there we go.
I was raised in a joint U.S.-Soviet-Chinese facility.
Where?
A sleeper agent. This was before the war. Back then, they were collecting children from all over the world. As a result, I'm indistinguishable from a native-born American. So it didn't surprise me when you and Volgan couldn't tell the
Did
difference.
Did you not get the real data? Hmm.
She knew right from the beginning. She knew because before the war, she was at one of the philosopher's schools, too, as an instructor. The boss was the only one I couldn't fool. She was the only one who knew I was a fake. She told me everything. Why did she open her heart to me like that? At the time, I couldn't understand it. But now, I think I do. Snake. She wanted you to know the truth. She chose me to tell you. That's why she saved my life. I've lied to you so many times, but not this time. My orders from the government were to obtain the legacy. And to eliminate everyone who knew the truth about what happened. In other words,
but I couldn't
kill you.
But I couldn't. Because love.
I can't do it. Not because we
oh,
love
sure.
each other. And not because
I just
we
can't.
My life.
Oh.
Because I made a promise to the boss. And I intend to keep it.
Now what will you do?
I just
want to. I'm on the run from like three governments.
And
crap. But I'm like, I guess in the 1960s that was an easier thing to do. Maybe. Just disappear. Poof. This message will self-destruct. And he's like, why am I not fucking surprised? So she was supposed to get the legacy, but then she decided not to. And decided to run from her mission instead. Well, crap. Meanwhile, other cutscene. More cutscenes.
Snake, listen to me. She didn't betray
yep, yep,
the United
yep.
States. No. Far from it. She was a hero who died
Fox.
For her country. She carried out her mission knowing full well what was going to happen.
Room full of bigwigs.
Self-sacrifice.
We're like, you are the best hero.
Because that was her duty.
On a mission that no one will ever know about. And your hair is multi. I'm important. I will give you this medal.
You are above
because you did
evil,
your mission.
Boss. I hereby award you the title of Big Boss.
Because that makes it more important. Big. He's like, I really don't give a fuck.
You.
And this is where a secret comes into play. Move the camera. There we go. Yeah, secret. If you press R1 during that time and then move it towards... Apparently Ocelot was hiding. Cat's out of the bag. I hadn't gotten that trophy last time around. Shit, it's like, I really don't care. Take your photo, shake my hand. Nope, not gonna do it. I'm leaving. Goodbye.
You know, we could use an infiltration unit like Fox
oh, crap.
Army. Someone like him to handle our top secret sneaking missions for us. A man who combines the qualities of a soldier and an agent.
The boss's defection.
Foxhound? Or the beginning of Les Enfants Terribles.
It was all a big drama staged by Washington.
I don't
remember. So they could get their hands on the philosopher's legacy.
That's the
and
next
the
game, not this
the
one.
Star of the show. They planned it so that they could get the legacy that Colonel Vulcan inherited, and destroy the Shagohod at the same time. Only a legendary hero like the boss...
Oh, wait, no, that was what Fox Hunt was established.
Finding out where the philosopher's...
Because they needed an infiltration unit in the army.
Everything was going according to plan.
And then blah, 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 next game.
But then something happened that no one could have predicted. Colonel Vulcan fired an American-made nuclear warhead at Sokolov's research facility. Khrushchev demanded that the U.S. government provide proof that it wasn't involved. They couldn't just abort the operation to steal the legacy. So the operation itself was greatly expanded and revised. The authorities in Washington knew that in order to prove its innocence, they had to get rid of the boss. And that one of their own would have to do the job. The public couldn't be allowed to find out about it.
Of course, never. Never, ever, ever.
This, they concluded, would be the best way to keep the whole thing under wraps. The boss wouldn't be allowed to come back home alive. And she wouldn't be allowed to kill herself. Her life would be ended by her most beloved disciple.
But he didn't end the horse's life. Because he cares for all the animals.
And she had no choice but to carry it out. Her death in your hands was a duty she had to fulfill. Out of duty, she turned her back on her own comrades. A lesser woman would have been crushed by such a burden. The taint of disgrace will follow her to her grave. Future generations will revile her. In America, as a despicable traitor with no sense of honor. And in Russia, as a monster who unleashed a
catastrophe. She's really a hero. But no one will ever know.
She will go down in official history as a war criminal. And no one will ever understand her. That was her final mission. And like a true soldier, she saw it through to the end. But I think she wanted you, of all people, to know the truth. She wanted to live on in your memory. Not as a soldier, but as a woman.
I'm not that.
But
it's so
she was forbidden to tell you herself. That's why she told
X. Why is there an X?
History.
Because it doesn't matter.
We'll never know what she did. No one will ever learn the truth. Her story, her debriefing, will endure only in your heart.
Yeah, those things happen.
Everything she did. Her life and her honor for her native land. She was a real hero. She was a true patriot.
Crying. The only time you'll see Big Boss cry. Ever. Blah, 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 history, blah, blah, blah. That we're supposed to integrate with this thing. ARPANET, the internet, paramedic. Bye, Ava. Paramedic in Seattle. That's cool. Disbands Fox. The Patriots. Foxhound. And then, of course, this last bullet point. The les effluents, and effluents terribles. And of course, we all know the history between there. Now it's time for credits, which I really don't care about. this music, though, but I think that's... there is. Yay! Okay. So that was Metal Gear Solid 3. Yay! I finished the game! Yay! So, next time, brand new game! Wait. I forgot. Where is it? There we go. Production Konami Entertainment. I forgot about this part. Sorry.
Yes, Grozny Grad and the Granin Research Facility have both been...
It's important.
I understand, sir, that they were necessary sacrifices.
Who is that?
Yes, the CIA has taken care of the boss themselves.
I'm like, who is he talking to? Is he talking to Khrushchev? Or... Okay, he's talking to some way in.
Your time is finally arrived.
Is he talking to Brezhnev?
Yes, the American president is...
Or the KGB? I guess he's talking to the KGB.
It should make a valuable trump card in future negotiations. Yes, Chief Director. I'll keep the KGB.
Yeah, I don't know who he's talking to. Is it KGB or Brezhnev? And then... Because this is Metal Gear. I'm like, well, I wonder where he is. He's just sitting like a Moscow hotel. Yeah, you know, just casually...
Yes,
talking.
The boss has accomplished her mission. Philosopher's legacy is now safely with us.
Dun dun dun.
This money. Yes, the philosophers can finally be revived. The film we handed the Chinese was a fake. Peking must be in an uproar.
Peking, Beijing.
I'm afraid so. Only half the money has made it back to the United States. KGB must still have part of the legacy. Yes, the weapon has been reduced to ashes. That's right. Grozny Grad has been obliterated by the Davy Crockett you brought in as well.
So did he know the boss personally?
Speaking of which, I've obtained something
that you might find interesting. It's called Metal Gear.
It's a revolutionary new nuclear attack system.
Yeah, perhaps because Metal Gear.
Come in handy someday. Yes, we have John.
Jack.
Snake to thank for that. Khrushchev, believe it.
Maybe
well.
He's talking to Khrushchev.
Yes, they bought our story. I don't think they'll be making a fuss. The secondary alert has been lifted as well. And the Soviets still haven't discovered my true identity. They have no idea that I've been triple-crossed.
You and Ava are the worst.
I will continue my activities as a contact.
It's like you're a KGB agent.
Yes. It appears that no
one... Adamska! So he was spying for the KGB and Granin and the CIA. Yeah, that's a big catch. Okay, so, new game, next time. Oh, apparently I'm an iguana. I don't know what that means. I don't really care because I was playing around. Iguana! Special items was not used. I killed 47 people, and how many times did I die? It doesn't say. I use life medicine 7 times. Eat 37 types of animals. Yay. Okay, next time. New game. Bye!